This is Deped Cagayan de Oro, now signing off.
Magbasa o magkwenta, ang siyensya, ang pilunta, ito na pa'y history o kultura, English, Mami o MTV, Filipino, ESP o EPP, oras na, magtuon na ta!
Mga bata, maayong adlaw kaninyo. Kumusta na mo?
Andaman yung mga gamit, kay magsugod na ang eskwelahan sa kahanginan.
Kini ang Learn O'Clock!
Magtuon kita karon, dinhi sa bagong panahon.
Ang mga lapis o papel, radyo, TV o computer,
smartphone o modules,
sa pag-invite sa imong higala.
Ang pagtuon dili maundang mo pa dayon pa.
Makat-on pag-iha, makat-on ta pagbasa.
Letters of the alphabet ang atong alpabeto.
Sa Learn O'Clock, where learning won't stop. And then andamo ng kaugalingon kay magsugod ng Learn O'Clock.
Good afternoon, children! Welcome to another episode of Learn O'Clock. I am Teacher Joy, your grade 3 teacher from South City Central School. How was your learning journey during the first quarter? I'm sure your teachers were able to help you in your lessons. This afternoon, we will be learning English 3, Module 1, Lesson 1, Quarter 2. We will be talking about and the use of be verbs like is, are, was, and were correctly in sentences. But before we discuss with our new lesson this afternoon, let's review what you have learned from your previous lessons. Can you still remember, children? Very good! You learn about nouns, noting details, sequencing events, elements of text, predicting, vocabulary, concept development, and many more. I hope those lessons become a part of you that remain in your mind and in your heart. Today comes another new lesson. This is not new to all of you, children. Before we begin, let's listen to this.
Students, today is Hina's chance to tell us about the different members of her family. Listen to her carefully. Hina, please come in the front.
Hello everyone. I am Hina. She is my mother, Mrs. Shanti. He is my father, Mr. Anil. It is my pet dog, Gogo. We are a small but a happy family.
Thank you for introducing your family to us, Hina. Students, did you notice the use of am, is, and are by Hina? Let me tell you a story about them. Far away in a land full of happiness, live three sisters named Am, Is, and Are. Am is shy and has only one friend, I. For example, I am a baby. I am a teacher. I am a student. Is has three friends, he, she, and it. For example, he is a boy. She is happy. It is my school bag. R also has three best friends. You, we, and they. For example, you are thirsty. We are going home. They are laughing. Now let us revise all that we have learnt in today's class. The word am is used with I. The word is used with he, she, and it. The word are is used with you, we, and they. I hope you all will remember today's learnings and use it in sentences correctly.
Did you learn something? This time, have your module in English 3, Lesson 1 ready. Turn your modules to page 1. Can you tell the be verb in each sentence? We'll see. Number 1. I am, is, an honor pupil in our class. Can you tell the answer? Yes, it's am. Number 2. They, is, are all good in English. What is your answer, children? If it's are, then you are correct. Number 3. I was, were, curious. Was is the answer. Do you get it? Number 4. The learners was, were awarded by their teacher. Where is the correct answer? And the last one. The baby are, is sleeping. Who answered is? Very good. You're correct. This time, I'll be reading to you a poem about My Family is a Worker. This is found on page 2 of your module. Are you ready to listen? Here we go. My family is a worker. My father is a firefighter. Uncle Sam is a police officer. Tito John is a soldier. They protect people who are in danger. Grandpa George was a farmer. He was also an expert in agriculture. Grandma Gina was a lawyer. She also works as a professor. Tita Lailia is a doctor. Aunt Becky is an engineer. Mother is a teacher. And I want to be like her. They were all hard workers. They were smart and dedicated. I am studying so hard so that someday I will become a teacher. The underlined words in the poem, as you see in your module, are the following. Is, are, was, and were. These words that indicate a state of being or existence are called be verbs. These verbs do not show action. They don't give any meaning, but they are used to describe a subject. Be verbs for singular subjects are am, is, and used for the present tense. Was is used for the past tense. Example, I am a boy. She is a girl. He was jailed. On the other hand, be verbs for plural subjects are for present tense and were for the past tense. Example: They are basketball players. The players were exhausted. Be verbs in the present tense. Present tense are those that are done habitually or at present time. Singular, you have is and am. And the plural is are. Past tense done in the past, like was for singular and were for plural. Present tense and past tense of be verbs are another topic which will be discussed in the coming days to come. As of today, our focus is on the be verbs only. You want some more examples? Please refer to your English 3 module on page 3. Can you fill in the correct be verb in the blank to make the sentence correct? Use is, am, are, was, and were. Number 1. Harry blank is a good chess player. Number 2. Our basketball team blank the best team last year. Number 3. Cats blank the best pets to have. Number 4. The babies blank crying last night. And number 5. I blank a citizen of the Philippines. Shall we check your answers? Number 1. Is. Number 2. Was. Number 3. Are. Number 4. Where. And number 5. Am. Who got 5 over 5? Very good! If you didn't get perfect, try on the next activity. Turn your module on page 4. Can you describe the following pictures using be verbs? You can do it with your ate or kuya or with your mother. Try to pick out the answer on page 4, activity 3, by choosing the correct be verb inside the box. I'll give you 1 minute to do that. Done? Let's see how well you can answer. And the correct answers are: Number 1, are. Number 2, is. Number 3, is. Number 4, where. And number 5, am. For the activity What I Have Learned on page 5, do it independently with the assistance of your siblings or parents. We are almost in the last part of our lesson, still on using be verbs correctly in sentences. I'll be reading to you a story about a vendor named Mang Tommy. So get your pen and paper ready. At the same time, write the appropriate be verb like is, am, was, are, and were to complete the story. And here is the story. Mang Tommy, blank a vendor. He sells meat, vegetables, and fruits together with his family. One day, Mang Tommy and his family blank walking along the streets and they saw a hungry lady lying. Mang Tommy helped the lady and gave her 3 big apples. You blank a good man. Thank you for this, said the lady. Mang Tommy gave another 4 kilos of meat to the lady. The lady walks and go home. The next day, while Mang Tommy was arranging his vegetables and fruits, a lady came straight to his stall. How much is that all you have on your stall? Said the lady. Mang Tommy was shocked. His family were also shocked. And they looked at the lady. They noticed that it was the lady that they helped the other day. I blank sorry for the trouble yesterday. I blank not able to introduce myself that I am the owner of this market where your stall is located. As a gift of gratitude, I will buy all the goods you have for this day, said the lady. Mang Tommy and his family blank very happy and they went home early. Do you have your answers now? Let's see and check if you got all correctly. If your answers on the blank are the following, on the first blank you have is. The next is where. Then followed by are. Then am. Was and where. If those are all your answers, then you got all correct. By the way, did you learn something valuable from the story about Mang Tommy? What important lesson does it teach you? That's right. It's about the golden rule that says, do unto others what you want others to do unto you. Children, take the lesson to your heart and make it yours for a lifetime. As we end, don't forget to answer on your own assessment on page 6 and additional activities on page 7. I hope you learned something from the episode today. Thank you for your time. This is Teacher Joy saying, stay safe and be blessed. Have a great day.
Thank you for listening and happy learning. DepEd Cagayan de Oro, now signing off.